In this lesson, we're going to create a new EC2 instance on Amazon Web Services. An EC2 instance is simply a virtual server that runs on AWS that hosts our application. We're going to be creating this server in the AWS console. We're going to assign a public key to the server so we can access it using SSH. And we're going to allow HTTP access to the server so we can access our API once it's installed and up and running. So let's get started. Start by making sure you're logged into the AWS console. I provided a link to the console in the resources of this video. Once you're logged into the console, you should see a page similar to this. It has options for all the different AWS products that they offer. The one we're going to be using is this EC2 one under compute. So if you click on that, it will take you to the EC2 dashboard page. Before we create our server, we need to assign our public key to our AWS account so that we can log into the server using SSH once it's up and running. We're going to use the same authentication method that we added to GitHub in the previous video. The way this works is we add our public key to our AWS account, and then when AWS creates our server, it automatically assigns the public key to the server it creates. So on the left-hand side of the EC2 dashboard, scroll down and find the key pairs option. Click on the key pairs option, and we're going to import a key pair. It's asking us for the public key contents. This is the contents of our public key file that we used earlier when we added it to GitHub. So if you don't already have it open, load up the terminal window and type atom squiggly line, which means the home directory, /.ssh/id_rsa.pub. This will open our public key in Atom Editor. Once it opens, copy the contents of the key and then head back over to the AWS console and paste the public key contents in there. We need to give it a name, so let's just call it whatever name you want. So I'm going to call it mark-desktop. You might want to use your name or your desktop name or whatever computer this key is for. Once you've typed that, you can click on import. All right, so now our key is imported into AWS. We can go ahead and create our server. On the left-hand side here, scroll up and click on the EC2 dashboard option at the top. Then click on launch instance here to create a new EC2 instance. We've got various options of operating systems we want to use for our AWS server. We want to find the Ubuntu Server 16.04 LTS version. You can see here it says that it's free tier eligible. That means that while you're in the free tier, which is for the first 2 years of signing up to AWS, you can use this server at no cost. So as long as you only create one of these servers, you won't be charged for it until the free tier period ends. So next to this Ubuntu Server 16.04 operating system, click on select, and then it's going to ask us what type of instance we want to create. Again, we want to choose one that is within the free tier eligible option. That is this T2 micro instance. A T2 micro instance has one virtual CPU and 1 GB of memory. This should be plenty to test and play around with our API. All right, so make sure that one's selected and click on review and launch. Finally, it's asking us to review the server that we want to create. So we can leave all of this default and then click on launch. Now it asks us if we want to assign a key pair to our server. We want to make sure the one that we added earlier, so in my case, Mark Desktop, is selected. And then just click on I acknowledge that I have access to the selected private key. And then click launch instance. Okay, so now our instance will be created in AWS. This can take a few minutes. So while we're waiting for that to happen, let's create a new security group that allows HTTP access into our virtual machine. So if you click on services again and you go back to EC2, on the left-hand side, we should have an option for security groups. So click on the security groups option and then click on create security group. We're going to call the security group allow HTTP access inbound. This means allow HTTP access into our server. So we'll give it a description, allows HTTP access to our server. And then on the inbound, make sure you have the inbound tab selected, click on add rule. On the type, you want to select HTTP. There it is. All right, it automatically chooses port 80 and it allows access to all IP addresses to our server on port 80. That's what this 0000 means. All right, so now we can create this rule, click on create, and then head back to the EC2 dashboard. Click on the running instances option and we'll see if our server has been created yet. All right, so we can see that the server is running. We need to assign our new security group to our newly created server. So click on actions here and then click on networking and click on change security group. You want to check the allow HTTP access inbound option and then click on assign security group. All right, so now that our server has been created, let's go ahead and connect to it. So if you click, make sure the server that we just created is selected here and click on connect. This will give us the details that we need to connect to the server on AWS. So we don't really need any of this other information. All we need is this line here. So the DNS or the public DNS address for our server. So copy that and then head over to the terminal window. Now type SSH and then paste the DNS name of our server and hit enter. Type yes. This just accepts the fingerprint and you need to do this the first time that you connect to any server. Okay, so we got permission key denied and that's because we need to specify the username that we want to log in as. So again, if you push the up arrow to get the same command that we just entered and in front of the DNS name, type the username ubuntu @. This says log in with the user ubuntu on this address. Then hit enter again. You can see this time it has connected us to the server. We can tell we're on the server because this part of the terminal window has changed to the host name of the server. Okay, so that's how you create and connect to a server on AWS. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful and I'll see you in the next lesson.